congratulations! You have made it to the next podcast. Rewind, go listen to the past three. I only like the past two, but I'm gonna go recommend the past three because I think, you know, like, come on, man, two out of three ain't bad. Damn, man, tell him, McNally.
Yes, it's Tim, News Bloomer's McNutley, and I have to agree with you, Picantrella. That is not bad at all. And this is a very special episode. It's the first episode that we actually have a sponsor. Is that correct, Picantrella?
That is absolutely correct. Let's just go ahead and get to it. Ladies and gentlemen, capitalism is being nice to us, so listen carefully.
Come on, come down to Bubba Truck Nuts. I'm telling you, we got truck nuts that are white and black and red and yellow. But I'm going to tell you something. We don't got those silver truck nuts because we don't come in second. We love America and we love the gold. Come on down to Bubba Truck Nuts. Bubba Truck Nuts, Bubba Truck Nuts, Bubba Truck Nuts, Bubba Truck Nuts, Bubba's Truck Nuts, Bubba's Truck Nuts.
Oh, yes. This is a German Shepherd Bus from a dying cat in an alley, bowling alley. You gotta keep them 10 pins. We keep you 10 pins. So come down to 9433 to Bolsonaro Boulevard. It's a first little warehouse. There's a little kind of cats all over the place. Them goddamn little kitties all over the place. Say that, hence the name, Dying Cats in the Alley, Sporting Alley. So come on down and join us. Wednesdays are double the price. Thank you.
That is Dying Cats in an Alley, Bowling Alley, on 9th Street. You'll find local souvenirs such as an Elvis plate that Bob Gifford broke. Come on down and see the Elvis plate that Bob Gifford broke at Dying Alley Cats, Bowling Alley. Located on 9th Street.
I'm gonna tell you something, McNally. Like, they paid the fuck out of us to run them ads, but them was some stupid ass. I know that ain't what you're supposed to do when you're doing an advertisement, but that was fucking stupid and stupid. I got a list. Stupid one, two is stupid. It's fucking retarded. I didn't mean to say that. My brother is half retarded, and I don't take that shit lightly. Oh, man, don't you fucking... Oh, don't you be talking about some retarded people. I am talking to a mirror right now. I didn't mean to use the word, but this time I wasn't using it in the sense of I was yelling at somebody. I'm looking at a mirror. Do you understand what I'm saying? Anyway, McNutley, we need to get to our guest. Who do we have here today? McNutley, I need you to tell me who we have here today and just let me go over here in the corner. I'm gonna smoke a fucking joint. Just call me if you need me, McNutley.
This is Tim, News Bloomer's McNutley, and might I add that those sponsors that we have are just plain pitiful. I cannot understand a single word that Dying in an Alley Cat Bowling Alley sponsor was trying to say. I thought he said 932 Street, but then his co-sponsor says 9th Street. There's something about a warehouse. I'm not really sure there, Picantrella, but it's just got my mind all kinds of just wrapped around some kind of nonsensical stuff going on. It just drives me bonkers.
McNally! You mean that the sponsors is good as shit, you know what I'm saying? I took a couple hits, man. We can't lose the sponsors, McNally. That's fucking stupid. Who the fuck came up with that idea, McNally? Fucking stupid. It's fucking stupid, you know what I'm saying? McNally, let me tell you something. Let's crack it again. Tell them about the sponsors.
Yes, it's Tim, News Bloomer's McNutley, and visit our sponsors, Bubba's Truck Nuts, where he sells the finest nuts that go on your truck for some reason. You can hitch those nuts onto your truck and pull into the Dying Alley Cat bowling alley and shoot a few games, or whatever it is they do there.
McNutley, I'm gonna be honest with you, you don't know fucking how to bowl, man. I'm gonna take you out to the bowling alley, man. The old 10 pin, you know what I'm saying? Motherfucker, I'm from 1942, the old 10 pin. Let's do it, man. Some damn milk bottles, a motherfucking cantaloupe. Why did I edit myself? We is on free radio, podcast, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I said, motherfucker, ooh, the old motherfucking 10 pin. Alley, big fucking Lebowski. McNally, bring in the guest.
Well, from our first guest, I think his name is Pierre Chong Fong Schwag Flat. Pierre something or another. He's a French photographer.
I am very much the French. You suck. You fucking American. You suck so hard. You suck so many penises.
Man, you a fucking French ass dude coming into my American house, motherfucker. I'm about to turn into Uncle Sam, point my finger right through your motherfucking heart if you don't step the hell back, motherfucking French toast, motherfucker. fucking French fry McNutley, you better get do something.
I'm sorry, Pierre. He's a little on edge today. Why don't you tell us a little more about your French photography expedition? So do you like travel all over the world or just Canada? Tell us about that.
I don't want to answer your stupid American questions. You can just ask all your questions to my assistant.
He's an assistant. My name is Conchelabon, Sivon, Siton, the third. We take all many of photography around Canada, Detroit, as you call it, because Detroit has so many photolistic opportunities that just break children's hearts.
What the fuck did you just say, man? I don't know one damn thing you said. I don't know one damn thing he said, McNally. How the fuck can I carry out with an interview with the motherfucker? I ain't saying not damn one logical... Man, just somebody say something. Say like I said this. The girl jumped. Yeah, man, talking about the subject and the verb, and I know what the fuck happened. Damn, I need that kind of stability in my life, McNally.
Excuse me, John Sean, whatever you were trying to say that your name was, what exactly do you have against, America, though?
The name is Jean-Luc Despair, and I fucking hate Americans, because you walk around, and you're like, I'm American, with my Florida and my Maine. Well, you're not the Maine anything, Americans. Ah, take care, assistant.
It's not to add on to what he was trying to say, it's like, we appreciate your country. For its contributions to a genocide. To fries, but you call them French fries. We just call them regular fries.
Oh, McNally, I'm fucking hungry. Let's go to McDonald's. Fuck this interview. Fuck these French people. It's over.
Oh, yes. Fuck the French. I'm hungry.